Before the 1981 football season, sports writers asked me, how would I compare our 1980 team with our 1981 team? I told them that on a scale of 1 to 10, that I thought that 1980's team, in comparison to the opponents that we play in the Pac-10 conference and our non-conference foes, rated zero. Rated at zero because of the overall talent that we had compared to our opponents, the toughness of our schedule, and really the closeness of our games. I then told them that I thought in preseason 1981 that we would be a three. A three based on the improvement of our personnel and what I thought we could accomplish. Started the season, and one of the things that I think about in looking back on our 81 season is the fact that I believe that at the beginning of the season we were playing as well as we could possibly play. And I think this is a great compliment to our football team. We were playing as well as we could play. We accomplished some things. And another thing that happened was we played a couple football teams that were equal to us in talent and experience, and it showed on the field because our team went out and did a very good job. We then played one of the toughest schedules in the country. And we had liabilities, or else I wouldn't have ranked us just a three. We had deficiencies. Our young men played hard and played enthusiastic, and we played better football teams. With the beginning of the season the way it was, it certainly raised a lot of expectations in our minds, fans' minds, and this is good because without expectations, you can't ever achieve anything. As the football team progressed through the 1981 season, we found that with some injuries and with the schedule, we certainly operated on a less efficient level. Now, what all this means is that our football team made improvements this year. Out of about a 60-man travel squad, this year there were approximately 38 to 40 of them that were new to this program. With the improvement and with the enthusiasm and with the deficiencies and liabilities that our team had, with all this put into one, it shows again the great opportunities that young men have in coming into this program and playing early and helping the program to improve. Because we've shown that step by step, we will improve.
The Beavers' home opener against the Bulldogs from Fresno State provided OSU fans with one of the most memorable games in the history of the university. The poise, determination, and excitement of the Oregon State team behind the inspired passing of junior quarterback Ed Singler and the receiving talents of senior Victor Simmons enabled Joe Avezzano's squad to post the biggest comeback in NCAA Division I history. Pinpoint passing to Simmons, juniors Ron Vogel, Tim Sim, and Armon Chong, plus the all-around offense of sophomore Randy Holmes led to a 31-28 victory on this warm Saturday night.
they're not in cover two, run 18.
At Baton Rouge, the Beavers rolled up 457 yards against the Southeastern Conference LSU Tigers. Again, the youth of the Beavers provided inspired play as sophomore Randy Holmes carried the ball 13 times, and the airways were filled by OSU passes. Junior Jerome Boyd, developing into a stalwart at his linebacking position, tallied 8 unassisted stops. Sophomore Mike Cagle and freshman Claude Dixon combined forces to tally over 130 yards in kickoff returns. ABC's cameras were out in force to record the flourishing talents of OSU's budding freshmen and sophomores as the Beavers took on Big Ten power Minnesota. Freshman tailback James Terrell found himself on the receiving end of a trio of passes from sophomore quarterback Jay Kirschenman, and then culminated that exciting drive by breaking through the Golden Gopher goal line defense for his first collegiate touchdown. Sophomore Mike Cagle also got exposure in front of a regional TV audience as he carried the ball 6 times. His roommate Randy Holmes continued to churn up the turf and finished the game sporting a seasonal average of over 6.5 yards per carry. The USC Trojans, bound for the Fiesta Bowl at the end of the season, may have been bigger, but Joe Avezzano's blooming offense was effective this day in a packed Parker Stadium. Mike Cagle's entrance into the game ignited the Beavers in the second half. And again, Randy Holmes played inspired football as he carried for over 90 yards against a tough Southern Cal defense. Ed Singler moved into fifth place on OSU's career passing list with over 220 yards against the Trojans.